Welcome to the 2023 State of the Steam channel. Let's get you updated on our ongoing projects and content plans for this year. Many of you inquired about the status for our Union Pacific 844 project. The latest installment covering the fabrication of the trailing truck was recently published across our sites. In the fall of 2022, a lot of changes were being made with the locomotive project. In early November, the project was relocated to Liam Locomotive Works, operated by Andrew Pullen in Maryland. Once delivered, the northern project was completely evaluated by Andrew, and thereafter some items were identified that Andrew and Jason are currently working to complete. Once these tasks are finished, Andrew will set out to complete fabrication work on the engine's valve gear and chassis, along with the smoke box, dual stack, and other components. The 844 is an excellent care at Liam Locomotive Works, as Andrew has extensive experience as a machinist and with live stream locomotive construction. Andrew has indicated he will send us routine video content and a steady stream of fabrication photos as the components for the chassis come together. Our build photo gallery on Flickr will stay updated with the latest updates. However, the official series installments may become more streamlined while this project is at Liam Locomotive Works. Jason's shop was 6.5 hours from our home base. Andrew's shop's approximately 11 hours away. Routine traveling for shop visits is not feasible for us, especially as Chris has a baby at home. In 2022, we completed several lingering projects in our shop. This included our nickel plate road flat car, a U.S. Army drop center flat car from Pacific Design Shops, two rounded end 55-ton Spayberry hopper cars, and a freight car storage rack. The script for the drop center video was completed and filmed. The video is currently in final editing, and this how-to will be published soon. After this is published, Chris began work on the script for the nickel plate flat car how-to video, which should be published later this spring. Our hopper car tutorial should be expected at some point over the summer, along with a how-to video detailing the construction of a freight car storage cart. In 2023, we have several freight car projects in our crosshairs. A lingering project, our wood Titan caboose, will get its final detailing this year and be put into service this summer. Once the caboose is out, we will start work on our two wood reefer kits from Pacific Design Shop. We'll have several new large-scale product reviews headed your way this year. These will include the Backyard Train Company GP35, Titan Trains -9, Reading Rail Cars SOG Ore Car, and numerous other freight car reviews. There will be numerous model train reviews as well. In 2024, we'll be partnering with Spayberry Hopper Car and Reading Car Company to build two standard hopper car kits as how-to tutorial videos. After this, we will have a box car kit to build and potentially two ore car kits. This will end our large-scale freight car building streak, and no additional car builds will be taken on. Our freight fleet has reached 23 cars, which is more than sufficient to horse around with. We also have 5 heavyweight coaches to construct. Fabrication and editing work on these projects are time-consuming, so we appreciate your patience. There will be a steady stream of new how-to content coming over the next several years for your enjoyment, though. With so many heavy steel freight cars entering service, it has become necessary to add a new road diesel to our roster. We are awaiting the first prototypes of a new electric locomotive kit coming to the market this summer. If everything looks good, we are tentatively looking to buy into this kit line and build the locomotive in a building series partnership with the vendor. We should have more direction on that project by late spring, and a project announcement video will be published this summer if it all works out. We'll address the elephant in the room, our big boy project. Discussions are ongoing with several of our contacts, so we have a preliminary plan to tackle the project. We have a machinist interested in completing the locomotive chassis to an on-air status, but no hard commitments have been made on either side. Another contractor has expressed interest in finishing off the Big Boy Centipede tender. Before we get too excited, we do not plan to start any work on the Big Boy before 2025 or 2026. Even after that work is started, it will take years to complete this massive undertaking. If we do move forward with the Big Boy, it will be the last large-scale locomotive project we undertake. Our travel dock for 2023 will be lean. Chris is taking time to enjoy his family this summer. His daughter was born early last fall, and a new little nephew arrived the month after. We don't expect to make more than one trip per month over the summer. Tentative travel arrangements have been made for the Big Creek and Southern Railroad, the White Creek Railroad, and the Buckeye Convention at the Mill Creek Railroad. We are also considering a fast 2-day trip to St. Croix Railroad in the fall, but that is tentative. We will work and visit to various local venues like the Illinois Railway Museum, local model railroad clubs, and local live steam clubs throughout the season. A lot of updates have been made to our website, thesteamchannel.com, over the winter. All live steam content is now centralized on the new Explore Live Steam page. Here you can find links to live steam and large-scale railroads, helpful informative videos, access a comprehensive list of hobby suppliers, and much more. We have also added a blog to the site, which will publish write-ups on live steam meets we attend and soup to nut build articles on our equipment projects. In anticipation of our shift into O and HO scale trains, we also created the Model Train Hub at the Steam Channel. This page on our website will become the central hub for everything model rail related on our website. Here too, a blog is built on the site which will feature written product reviews for freight and passenger cars, event write-ups, and much more. We have spent the winter working on our train room, and this project is ongoing. We are aiming to have the lion's share of this project completed by the end of the year. Once this is finished, we'll begin design work on our future HO and O-scale layouts. These train layouts will be built together in stages. The bench work will be the first phase, the track work will follow accompanied by wiring work, and finally, the scenery will be tackled on each layout. We look forward to bringing you our Model Railroading Institute covering these layout builds and much more educational content. We are open to collaborating with any other model railroader YouTuber, and we encourage you to reach out to us. Until then, we have a lot of new model railroad reviews and blog spotlights coming down the pipeline for you in 2023. We have numerous items on pre-order from Lionel, Atlas, Broadway Limited, and Rapido, which we look forward to reviewing in the coming year. This will tentatively include the Vision Line Big Boy, the new Dreyfus Hudson, and Frisco 1630. Thank you for joining us on the 2023 State of Steam Channel video, and we hope you enjoyed it. My name is Blake Bichoux, you're watching Steam Channel, and we'll see you next time.
Thank you for watching this video here on the Steam Channel. We hope you enjoyed it. Shovel on more coal to the fire and enjoy another high-quality Steam video by clicking on one of the video previews to your right. Consider subscribing to the channel so you won't miss our future content.